Cameron and Wanda, from the beginning, Joseph Abbott maintained his innocence. There was never any DNA placing him at the scene of the 1991 rapes. That was the case until now.
A year ago, Joseph Lamont Abbott was all smiles as he left the Forsyth County Courthouse, cleared of two life sentences in the 1991 attack and rapes of two Winston-Salem girls.
We were diligently investigating this because it was our intent to try and find and identify the true attacker.
A judge cleared Abbott of the charges at the request of the DA and the North Carolina Center for Actual Innocence. The original rape kick test results did not find Abbott's DNA inside the victim.
We continued to investigate the case and we reviewed all the evidence again.
Evidence the chief of police now says links right back to Abbott.
The nuclear DNA of Mr. Abbott was found on the sheets of one of the attacked victims.
That means
there's one suspect. And as Chief Cunningham stated, that prime suspect is Joseph Abbott.
So according to police, they let the wrong man out of prison. Abbott received a lot of support from Daryl Hunt. Since his release, Abbott worked closely with the Daryl Hunt Project for Freedom and Justice. The offices were closed and no one has commented yet about the latest DNA evidence. The chief says Abbott isn't willing to talk either.
And we asked to interview Mr. Abbott, try to get his story of what happened and why this DNA, why his DNA was found on those sheets. Those requests have not been granted.
So you may ask yourself, what's next in this case? The police department hands over its findings to the Forsyth County DA. Interesting enough, Jim O'Neill was not in the office. He was actually out of town and did not return any of my phone calls. Now, the big question is whether or not the double jeopardy rule applies in this case. Under double jeopardy, you cannot be tried for the same offense twice. So at this point, it begs the question as to what will happen to Mr. Abbott, his freedom, and all of that is going to be played out when Jim O'Neill gets back in town and reviews the findings of the police department. Reporting live outside the Forsyth County Hall of Justice, Jermont Terry, WXII 12 News.